crack down on illegal dumping throughout Red Hook. And he has also always done the right thing by the community and always hires locally. So I knew this was somebody that I could work with and that I could trust.
Hi, my name is John Cabrera. This is the Juanes Bay Terminal. A little history, Juanes Bay Terminal was created in 1922 as part of the Erie Canal project. It was a place to bring that grain out and distribute it around the world. The terminal was built all on landfill. In fact, the property had water going all the way back as far as Bay Street at the time. And then it was built close to the configuration that you see here in this photo. With the exception of right here, this is called, this is referred to as the Henry Street Basin. So the Henry Street Basin, actually, even in the 20s, when it was filled, went all the way up to Bay Street. Then in 1945, the terminal was transferred to the Port Authority. At that time, the basin was filled to what we see now, where it goes down to Howard Street. Part of those lands went to the Parks Department. For example, here, and I think in a portion here, I'm not that sure where there was some park here. Most of this park actually came from this terminal when it was transferred in the 40s. It remained active until 1965. There were some other uses, break bulk like lumber and that kind of sort, but mostly it was just continued to use the grain. As in 65, it shut down, and then they followed. There were some sporadic uses, like police use it for training obstacle course with cars or helicopters flying around, different activities. For the most part, it deteriorated. Whatever uses were there were not inside the building itself. That's actually another picture of the silo building, the silo building was the worst situation. This building became what was similar to I always refer to as New Jack City. It was a sort of a crack den, a house of prostitution, and nobody went in this building except noxious users. In fact, even the police told me that they were warned they can't go into this building. And for the most part, this activity came in through the park. There were holes in the fence and so forth. So we bought the property. It was quite an endeavor to close it off and get the inhabitants, I'll call them, used to not coming into the property. So little by little, we were successful, and that use, that kind of noxious use ended. At the time when we bought it, there were still prostitutes and so forth walking on Bay Street, and you can see that noxious activity outside of the park. That's all since gone. Because everything in the facility is now put back to productive use, including the silo building. Even though it's not used for grain right now, which is what it used to do, it has become a favorite of the film industry. So we have as many as two photo shoots sometimes a week in the silos. Most of your top stars, directors, Martin Scorsese, Beyonce, Janet Jackson, and so forth, they all come here. And the high fashion shoots like Vogue, Italia, Teen Vogue, Elle, etc. So it's really a favorite because it's sort of that run down seeming very natural. Another use here in this northern area, number one, it says sea container depot. This is where containers, the sea containers that come off the ships in New Jersey, are brought and stored. They're often shipped to customers here locally and then come back into the facility and then shipped off to New Jersey. This area here, number four, it's similar activity. It's sorry, I'm not going in order, but just trying to match the uses. In four is a bus and truck depot. The trucks that are there mostly handle the containers. Otherwise, there are these coach buses that you see in Chinatown and so forth, doing a lot of the local transportation. And this area over here, number three, this is what we refer to as a bulk handling area. Yeah. No recycling, manufactured concrete aggregate. So there's a scrap area here that handles heavy metal. This is not a recycling operation, for example, where you take individual concrete that comes out of foundations and is demolished. This is actually a residual concrete that comes out of concrete trucks themselves, either being unused, there's over-ordering, spent useless, if it has some sort of a defect, and it comes back. So the material is crushed, made into different gradations,